With the unrest with ISIS continuing to grow, a number of Republican lawmakers are demanding that the president clearly explain what our strategy is for fighting these militants.
It's about time now to assume the worst about these guys rather than underestimating them. They're not the JV team anymore. They're the most prominent terrorist organization in the world, but they're not the only one.
This is an administration which the kindest word I can use is feckless, where they have not outlined a role that the United States of America has to play, and that's a leadership role. No more leading from behind.
Lieutenant Colonel Oliver North is a Fox News military analyst and author of Counterfeit Lies. Colonel, good to have you here this morning.
Martha.
I spoke a little while ago with Rear Admiral Kirby about the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, Martin Dempsey's comments over the weekend, and he suggested, Dempsey suggested, that it's not time yet for airstrikes in Syria, that they pose a regional threat, ISIS, but it's not clear whether or not they pose a threat to us here at home. Your thoughts on that?
Well, the O team is apparently very confused about who the enemy is and how much of a threat they are to us and what to do about it. Our intelligence services and the FBI are focused on the individual who murdered James Foley as if we're going to send in a SWAT team to arrest him and then prosecute him somewhere. They've just ordered a second carrier strike group to deploy to the Pacific because last week a red Chinese jet did a barrel roll over a U.S. Navy P-8 flying in international waters. So you have to wonder what the devil U.S. objectives really are. And as you just pointed out, SecDef and the chairman of the Joint Chiefs said that ISIL is a serious and imminent threat last week. John Kerry described it as an evil that must be destroyed. POTUS said it's going to be contained. Then when people harm Americans anywhere, we'll do what's necessary. On Friday, Ben Rhodes said, if we see ISIL plotting against us, we'll take action against them. But our military objectives in Iraq are going to be limited to protecting U.S. personnel, installations, and supporting humanitarian ops. In other words, it seems like the Obama administration is looking at two different ISILs, two different enemies. It turns out that Barack Obama really is the captain of the real JV team. Here's what we ought to be doing. We ought to immediately deploy a second carrier battle group to the Mediterranean, a carrier strike group. And we've right now only got one in the Persian Gulf. And so before you started serious air operations anywhere in the region, to include Syria, you're going to have to send out a second carrier, perhaps even send out a whole Marine Expeditionary Brigade. There are 3,000 ISIL terrorists who carry U.S. and European passports. And so there ought to be an expression that there are no safe havens. They ought to be attacking ISIL high-value targets, logistics sites, and command and communication nodes in Iraq and in Syria. Does anybody remember Anwar al-Awlaki? Yeah. We killed an American citizen in Yemen going after him as a high-value target. Why the devil we can't go into Syria is beyond me. And that's probably al-Baghdadi is.
This is more of a political question, but with your background, you know, I'm sure you have thoughts on it, because Dempsey and Hagel were much more aggressive sounding at the end of last week than they were over the weekend. So what do you think happened in between?
Well, I heard the admiral deny that they'd gotten any guidance from the White House. They may have gotten it from an airplane. It's inconceivable to me that they could do such a reversal without somebody picking up the phone and say, hey, guys, back off. Bottom line of it is, I will be at that American Legion convention tomorrow speaking just before the commander in chief. I'm going to listen very carefully what he has to say to 5,000 or 6,000 of America's veterans in the American Legion are gathered down there in Charlotte. I quite frankly surprised they have me on just before him. I'm going to try to temper my remarks to make sure that I'm not going to make another enemy down there too.
Well, it'll be interesting to hear what you say, and interesting to hear absolutely what the president says about this. In terms of building a coalition, you know, what do you see in that effort so far? Because it seems to me that this is an enemy that, you know, doesn't really have any friends out there. It ought to be fairly easy to get people together against this group.
You know, there's only one group in that part of the world that's actually standing up to protect Christians and the minorities that are being murdered and massacred by ISIL, and that's the Kurds. Unfortunately, not one single bullet has arrived from the United States. We now have, of all things, we're getting support from the Czech Republic. We're getting support from East Europeans. But America's not getting the stuff delivered to the Peshmerga that they need. What this president needs to do is to go to Congress, ask for an urgent defense budget supplemental, stop talking about things that we won't do, like no boots on the ground, get some joint tactical air controllers and forward air controllers out there in small teams with the Kurds to make sure that we target the right things, not these pinprick strikes that we've been doing to support so-called humanitarian operations. Mm. They need to start rebuilding a human intelligence capability that we don't have today. And all along this, Martha, they've got to remember that the Ayatollahs in Tehran, Vladimir Putin, and the Red Chinese are watching. So it's time for this president to lead. Call an international summit right away. Not don't wait 2 months, don't wait till the first attack occurs here, and start going after these people before they can bring something to bear against us in the homeland.
Colonel North, thank you very much.
Martha.